Chris Trott here at Taylormade headquarters, Carlsbad, California. This is the Kingdom, our test facility. In front of me, I have the Hyto and the Milled Grind 3. Where do you go with making your choices? What sort of player are you? Where does it put you in which category? The Milled Grind 3 has the raised micro rib in there. So on a golf shot that you're going to play, where you're putting in off-speed shots, you're going to try and pitch that 50-yarder, just where you put it out there, you will see benefits with this club, and you could see it right there, how it one bounce grabbed against that hill and ripped back. You'll see huge benefits as you go with this golf club. In the high toe, there are other areas to consider though. You have that character high toe. The grooves go all the way out to the toe. So if you're a player who likes a flop shot, or you tend to cut across your wedges a lot, the mass and the grooves out towards the toe are going to be something that you will utilize and leverage. Now, on the tour, we often see when a player gets a golf ball, and you can see it here, it's just sat on the rough, it's sat up. It's a sticky situation, it happens a lot. Quite easily, we can go underneath that example there I did, and you can see from the strike that the wedge was struck higher in the blade. So it gives energy for that shot when you're in a lie where you're not quite sure where your low point. Chipping is all about the low point. It's all about, as we chip, where the ball position is, as we control the low point, you're not quite sure how the low point is going to react in rough like that. The high toe has distinct reasons to go for it and choose that club because of the mass high in the design. But when you look down, they're two very different looks. They're two very different wedges. You might be someone who wants a more traditional look of the Milled Grind 3, therefore make that choice and go for that wedge. Or if you want something that gives you a little bit more versatility and you are going to have to get creative, it's going to give you speed on off-center strikes, or you love a flop shot and you're going to cut across and sometimes leverage the toe section, high toe is going to be the club for you. The most important thing about testing wedges, and I say this to everyone I come across, tour players are brilliant at it, be creative, have fun. Hit different flights, hit different shots. You can see here, I've put golf balls out there in all different areas as I'm trying different flights and different contact points and different turf interaction with the wedges. That's how ultimately you're going to come to your decision as to which one of these great products you go for.